NYC. I am super excited about this segment this month. I have my guest with me today. Hi, Jillian. This is Jillian Davis. She is a gorgeous dancer with Complexions. So Jillian, because it is a Pointe shoe channel, I was wondering if you would show us how you like to break in your shoes and anything you like to do that maybe would help the young students out.
Absolutely. Let's do it.
Awesome.
So Jillian, I thought you could talk to us about how you prepare your shoes.
Yes.
And it looks like you do quite a bit to your shoes. So like, say, take us from when you get a brand new pair.
Right. So nice and shiny. Love them. Very hard. So what my first focus is shiny. I want to make sure that it bends a little bit lower than my arch because then I'm going to glue at that area and I can have that more suppleness.
So it's a little bit below 3/4, say?
A little bit. Like, I'll probably do it at the seam. My arch is actually pretty high on my foot, and then I have a very straight foot.
Yeah.
As you can metatarsal.
Yeah, yeah.
So, like, my toes kind of finish the Pointe instead of, and when I'm on Pointe, it's just kind of a straight shot.
Ah. Okay.
So I try to go a little bit lower to allow a little more flexibility in the bottom part of my metatarsal. So I just kind of put my thumbs right where the seam is, and then this is where the muscle work comes in. You just press down and really get in there and start getting the flexibility happening so that...
Oh, that makes a big difference.
Yeah. So then you just kind of do it both ways. And with the serenades that I'm bringing in right now, they actually don't really go too much this way, so it adds the support just with the shoe itself.
Yeah, it has to do with the construction of the shoe. I think that's a Texon shank in there,
yeah.
So it doesn't... Texon, we'll probably cover this in an episode, but it doesn't have the same memory that another shank would, so you have to keep...
Yeah, because like even these shoes that I have, I did break them in slightly more different, still a little bit below my arch, but they bend much more easier in this area than the resistance that I get with the Serenon. So with these shoes in particular, I actually 3/4 them, so I cut so that there's a little more flexibility because they kind of push me over.
So did you take like a box cutter and just cut that?
Yeah, I have a box cutter, exacto knife, however you want to say it, and I didn't slice all the way through because over time I'm going to keep breaking it in.
Oh,
so
okay.
the first layer of my shank, I over time it broke all the way through, and then the second half, that's the hard cardboard underneath.
And now you need that back piece in there, right?
Yes,
because
I still
too
want
much.
Yeah, I still want that support in there.
Okay.
And I don't want to have my heels sitting down too far. So those are two kind of things that I usually do with the shanks.
Okay.
And then with jet glue, or I use hot stuff.
Okay.
I'll glue right, so the arch is happening here, and I'll glue right in that area.
And that just gives you like a little extra support in that area.
Yeah, because that's the first thing that's going to go for me.
Right.
And then over time, if I need more support lower down, I'll just continue to glue down as I go.
Now, how about the box? What do you do? And I've also noticed that you dart the tips.
Yes, I do. So I find that darning does help with the longevity of shoes. It also helps kind of just make a platform for me. Sometimes things can go awry, and over time as they die, it just kind of helps.
And then do you kind of mush out the box or anything, or is that...
Yeah, I try not to do too much, just because over time... So usually, actually, what I do is I'll turn it over. I can show on this. I turn it over on this side, and I'll break it in here.
Okay.
I'd rather have my shank feel softer
in
this area than have the box.
Yeah.
So I'll stand up and I'll put the weight of my heel into the shoe.
Okay.
That way.
And also, some people may not be aware. What I've noticed is the free Pointe shoes stretch a lot and shoes stretch quite a bit too.
Yeah.
So if you fit them too loose, or if you break them in too much from the get-go, then you get this overstretch thing that messes you up later on.
So yeah, I've definitely discovered that. I always thought I had a wide foot, which is true in most cases. Usually with free dive, I would be a 3X or something. But for Bloch, I have actually fit myself more narrow because it does widen.
It does stretch.
So the first like few steps are a little uncomfortable. Once everything starts flattening out, it's pretty snug.
Yeah. So I was wondering, Jillian, since you're such a gorgeous dancer, do you mind dancing for us on camera?
Sure.
Why not?
Okay, let's do it. Thanks for watching.